Hello, Boris Pravisham here, back on the Nidd server. I did have a project that I was going to do today, but my plans for it didn't go so well. There's part of it. I was going to try and make a ferry system from here down to the edge. I'll just fly down here while I'm talking. We went down here in the last video, down to the... I believe Chessmaster has called it the Platform of Justice. It's supposed to be a secondary communal base down here. And he built it to be safe from meteors, but I don't know if we'll end up using it like as a replacement. But I think this would be a perfect place to set up a factory, a place to build ships. It might not necessarily be communal. It might indeed be owned by Chessmaster and he can lease it out to build ships in, because it's a nice big open area. You can make some rather large things in here. Not that we're, you know, going to make massive ships on a multiplayer server. There's only so far you could go with that before crashing everything. But it's a long way away. You know, coming back and forward with materials and sharing materials between the two bases is going to be quite annoying. So I wanted to find a way to link the two. Is it still here? No, it looks like it completely exploded. So what I was going to do was build a gravity tram system. You've probably seen these on the workshop before if you've had a little look around, and I've built them a couple of times myself. However, they were in creative and not over such a distance as this. I mean, how far is that? 1.8 kilometers and at an angle. So that's why I've got that orange thing, if you can see it. It was in the earlier in the video. Just to the right of my crosshairs. That was to try and target, and I had a rotor system set up here, which is why it's drilled away, so I could turn it. I had like an X and Y axis to try and pinpoint the location. And then I built, well, right up to the base, a long line of armor blocks, just normal armor blocks, all the way up. It took me quite some time to build 1.8 kilometers worth of a line of armor blocks all the way up to here, and I started to try and line it up. You see, it was a bit difficult because, you know, a rotor turning 1.8 kilometers worth of armor blocks, it wasn't exactly a quick process, but I started to line it up. It was bouncing around too much and glitching a little bit, but then, of course, the meteors came in, which I had completely forgotten about, and put a hole not far from the start of it. So I got some merge blocks, and I aligned them back up, and I managed to get them back into place. It took me over half an hour to get, and then they clipped together. And, of course, I wasn't really expecting anything else, but they clipped together, and because it was a merge block on a rotor, it just glitched out and everything exploded. That hole on that moon asteroid was half created by that, and it's somewhere out there now. There's a line of armor blocks just floating away. This world does have a 200 kilometer what do you call it, like world size, so once it reaches that, it'll disappear. So I'm not sure if that'll be counted as garbage to be removed, but you see, I'm not even sure that would have worked. The reason I built that 1.8k line is because my tests in a creative world, I found it almost impossible to try and get an unmanned thing, object driven by gravity, to get to an accurate enough point so that it could ferry back and forward. And I don't really want to build like a conveyor system from here to there. That'd be a big job. I mean, I could do it if there was no other option. I'm not sure I want to sort of overload the world too much. I'm not sure what sort of an effect that would have on the server. But I'm taking suggestions. I'm not sure anything will work at this stage in the game, but I think it would be really nice to have a system where you could press a button, because, you know, with the new additions, you can make those gravity tram systems where you can just press a button and it'll go and clip on down there. I got mine to clip on with merge blocks and a connector, all automatically. But that was in a straight line, in a creative world where it was all exactly perfect as far as accuracy. But when you're down on this angle that you would have to manually put into a rotor, I'm not sure I can get a pinpoint target for a ship to go clip onto a merge block down there automatically and then be able to press a button there that would shoot it back up here and clip onto a merge block up here. So you could go back and forward at the click of a button. And of course, you know, be connected by a connector so you could load goods in and out of the ferry. And then you could also sit in there and use it as a train. So I'm not sure if that's going to work. Perhaps you have a better idea of having some sort of at least semi-automated system, because I think it would be interesting. I like the idea of having a ferry. It might not be possible after all, you know. We just have to keep flying down there. Anyway, that's not what I was going to do in this video. I just thought I'd give you an update on what I've been doing the past couple of days and how it all ended horribly, and see if you had any better ideas on that. What I want is to do another aesthetic thing. I fixed up this room a little bit, just lit it up and gave it a nice whitish floor so we could see. I wanted to do something that isn't useful, as very few of my things are. I wanted to make a drone again. You see, Falcus, on the day one, I didn't get this in the recording, it was a bit later, but he made a drone that would just continuously circle around. Now, this one had a gun on it, a Gatling turret to fire at meteors, and he also... There were two. I'm not sure if it was the first or the second one that had the gun, but I think the first may have just been a test that ended up actually barreling into the side of the station. I think that's Bathmat's new ship. yeah, so I think he rebuilt that one, sent it going, and once he knew it worked, he sent another one out. But because it ran out of fuel, well, I'm assuming it ran out of fuel, like I said, and went off, I want to make another one, because I really liked the way that they were just circling around, and I'm going to make it solar-powered. I think what I'll end up doing here is just cutting back and forth as I make things. This is actually going to be the first small ship I've ever made in survival. I've only made large ships up until now. Hopefully we've got a few more of those. 1,000, we're running out of steel plates. We're running out of iron. Okay, well, at least small ships are very small. of course they are. I mean, not very resource intensive. So I think what I want to do is make a sort of satellite looking thing. You know, more in the vein of a traditional satellite with a couple of solar panels and an antenna. And it's not that it's going to be very, you know, useful, but I want to, you know, it's a sort of communications a surveyor. I did also get the suggestion, who was it? Ronan, I think it was. He's a regular commenter on the videos. I hope it was Ronan, but he suggested that we turn this into a communications room. I think I might do that, at least around the sort of top half anyway. And I've completed some of the glass here. Oh, what's this? Must have been a meteor impact. Anyway, I'm going to start, and I'll come back when I've got something a little more solid. Okay, so let's have a little look at what we've got here. It's sort of satellite-y in shape. I had a bit of trouble building things like this, so it was a bit challenging. you have to imagine it without this. This is just anchoring it to the ground so it doesn't float away. And without that, the cockpit is also going to be going. That's just so I can control it and point it in the right direction. Then I'll get out, destroy the cockpit, and operate it through this button over here instead. Now, I was going to have just the two solar panels, and they were both going to face the same way. As you know, you often see solar panels on actual, you know, spacecraft facing the same way, obviously because it rotates along with the sun. But there's no way to make that automatically happen, because remember, this is going to be unmanned, flying around. So I've had to rig up a system where no matter where it is relative to the sun, except... Oh, no, it should be right. I think I've got all our angles here. So wherever it is relative to the sun, it should be powered just enough. Now, it will be overloaded. Like, there isn't enough of a power source to power everything on, which we'll go through in a second, but it's enough. I'm pretty sure it's just enough to keep it going. Now, down here, I was originally just going to have one thruster sort of to keep it buffered, because we obviously need the rear one. Well, we don't need it. We could rely on inertia, but it's just much easier in multiplayer, because you know we can't go attaching another. That thing's still in the corner. We've got to fix that sometimes. And there's a welder down here. I wonder who dropped that. We can't say get another ship and lock onto that one with the landing gear, because in multiplayer it'll desync and, you know, explode. So it's just a lot easier to have something that's actually constantly powered, and these other thrusters will keep it from going off course. We want it to stay in a steady orbit. Thankfully, the thruster mechanics are a little unrealistic in this game, and that everything's sort of linear, because that means I was able to break it up a little bit and have a bit of asymmetry here, so that I could put the other thrusters that were needed over here. So we got one facing in every direction. I was just going to have the one facing away from the... So if the orbit's like that, I was going to have one thruster facing out that way just to keep it balanced, but I couldn't get an orbit that was exactly like that in creative testing with a different drone. I've made a couple of drones in creative just to make sure that I could do it. So I've just gone with every way just to be safe. And of course, the primary reason is that antenna. I think I'm just going to call it a ComSat communication satellite, which I should change. It's not going to really do much, but hopefully if it's in range of this station, it's going to be within range, so it's going to be within 5,000 meters, which, I mean, it should be. Then I can control it. Unless something goes wrong, then I can control it from here. The debate I've been having is whether to set it up and make it go close to that 5,000 meter limit, sort of orbit at about 4,000 meters, so that it actually sort of is a bit more functional. It adds a bit more, a bit more of a reach than just this station alone. You know, so that it, if you know how the antenna mechanics work, so that it relays to that communication satellite that's orbiting at full speed around this, and then it gives me a little bit more reach. But there's also the aesthetic aspect of it, which is that I want to kind of be able to see it. It was really nice with Falkus's drones. They were only about 800 meters away, just orbiting around this way, which meant that you could look out the door and just see a drone fly past, which was quite nice. So, even though, I don't know, maybe people will disagree with that, but I think I want this a bit closer, maybe within 2,000 meters, because at least then you can still see a speck if your render distance is far enough. And also, it's easier to launch this one, just because of the way things are. That asteroid down there is actually a bit of a it might be a, what's the word? It might get in the road. I'm sure there's a better word for it than that, but we might end up crashing into it, the same with that one down there, if we're not careful. So that way, a loop, actually it was that way, is the safest option, but we also don't get to see it as much. I think I'm going to try on the same plane as this station. I think that's what I'll do. So, stupidly enough, you know, kind of like building a boat in your basement, I couldn't get it out the door, so I actually had to move the solar panel over to there and open this up a bit wider. And I also realized that without those solar panels being in the sun, I couldn't power the thing. So, should I put a reactor on there just temporarily to fly it out? Or should I try and bump it out? Let's go with the reactor. It's going to be... It'll be... I haven't set up my hotbar, of course. I'll be back in a second when I've got that on. Reactor on and powered. Now we've just got to get it out of here. That shouldn't be too difficult now. I was going to... I thought this was actually going to be the difficult part. But... Ooh. Okay, that gyroscope's touchy. There's no forward thruster. You've just got to be a little careful not to whack anything on the way out. And just sort of... If you don't have a forward thruster, that movement side to side really helps, because you can use those side thrusters just to slow you down a little bit. And of course, spin around entirely. Now, I think if we go out, we've just got to put this on. So if we look at the Barack Obama platform beacon... We're going to go out about, how far do you think? Maybe 900 meters, and that gives it a little bit of room, a little bit of play for the orbit, you know, not being quite as accurate as we'd like, if any of that makes sense. How far away? I think that'll be all right, because from my... very limited testing, we've got to watch out for that asteroid as well. My very limited testing, it suggests that it takes a couple of orbits for it to settle down. Until then, it doesn't find a rhythm. So, you've got to be a bit careful. So we've got... What are those solar panels looking like? There's 3, 2, and 1. I'm just really hoping this doesn't crash. So we face it in about that direction. I'm going to get out, and we'll grind... down things we don't need. That, we go for the landing gear next. Ooh. It's a bit difficult grinding with lag. So you end up grinding things you don't intend. There. And now the reactor. Grab the uranium out so we don't lose it. There. Come on. There. Now we've just got to get this reactor off without destroying everything. Everything's still powered. I think it should be at about 70% power. I think that's what I worked out, just sort of back of the envelope. I should have tested that before I got out, before I ground the cockpit down. So next, you see that's the name. We've also got in the info, do you have to actually be in, like, the cockpit of the ship to change the ship name? I didn't know that. Okay, so we've got the rear thruster and the gyroscope. We'll just switch them off for now, just to make sure. Nothing goes wrong, and then we've got the thrust override, which will be at full. That'll mean that the rear thruster down here is just going to constantly push it forward, and then the other thrusters will keep it steady, and this gyroscope will intentionally not keep it steady, because it'll provide a little bit of a yaw override. I think it'll be... No, it'll be a pitch override. So we want it to go that way. I've put this gyroscope on that way. So if we picture it this way, that means the pitch has to go down, because yaw's that way, pitch is that way and rotate is like that. So we want the pitch to go down a little bit. If we just go back into here. So this is where the... I want to underestimate to start with, because then from the station I can control it. 0.4, that's too far. It's going to be a negative anyway. It's a bit odd how this works, because that actually puts it at 4 RPM, not 0.4. That looks a bit better. I'm hoping that works. Yes, as I was saying, if this goes wrong, I should be able to control it from the station. I just don't want to overestimate and have this barreling into the thing. Anyway, you probably want me to just shut up and do this. So we switch them on, and away it goes. Now, is it going to turn? It is. It's turning away. Now, we should, because it's got the antenna, we should be able to track how sort of even its orbit is, and adjust from there. I probably shouldn't have started it so close. So far out, I mean, because if that isn't going to come in and hit the station, is it? Come on. This is probably a bit more nerve-wracking for me, because it's actually taken 3 days to record this due to an internet outage. The cut in between me saying I'll go build it and me saying I've built it was over 48 hours. Please don't hit that asteroid, just simply due to an internet outage. So I really don't want this to fail. Please don't just go straight into that asteroid. It's not going to be recoverable, is it? All of this empty space. I couldn't have got it that much more accurate if I'd tried. It looks like it's just taken out the thing. Let's see if we can stop this. I've got it. So we want to turn off these. Switch that off. Thruster, we'll disable that. And switch back on. And the gyroscope, like that. So now it'll just sit there. So it looks like the damage was just the solar panel. I guess that's the good thing about there being a bit of a multiplayer bug, where damage doesn't work properly. So it's just taken out that one block. What's the best way to recover this? Because I can't fire a ship out and grab hold of it and bring it back. Can I knock this out so I can just go grab the materials and put a solar panel on it? I think that would have been a perfect orbit. Yep, I'm not going to be able to knock this, because, again, multiplayer. It just sort of... it's a solid block. I think I'm going to have to get the supplies to put a cockpit on it. What else will I need? So just a cockpit and a solar panel. Okay, I'll go do that. Back in a second. Right, let's rescue this thing, shall we? There we go. Put on this cockpit. That's all I need. And now I should be able to... very carefully... bring it up. I don't want to break anything else. And we don't have any movement. Good. And we'll chuck this one on. So I want it around there. I had it like that. Now I think what I'm going to do is take it a little bit around further than that. What? I've left one solar... wait, will it work like that? No, it's not at all, is it? Seriously? And I've left a construction component behind as well. I think the wiki may be wrong. I've been using the wiki to... and there's no message received from the server. This has been the most stressful video to make. As I said, it's taken me 3 days to do this, and that no message received from the server means that the server has crashed again, which has been the fifth time while just doing this a little bit, which means everything from the past, well, basically since I logged on, because I've only been on for 5 minutes, is now erased. It'll revert back to the last save. And it takes me about 5 minutes to log into this world, because it's 12 megabytes in size, and apparently that's all Australian internet can handle. I'll be back shortly. This game is lucky I'm addicted to it, because it can't half get annoying. Let's fly a little bit further away from that asteroid, shall we? We'll get on the other side of that, those rocks there. You can see that we're about 1.5 kilometers from the platform, so it did go a bit further out than that 900 meters that we started at, or nearly 1,000. So at least that prediction was correct. I'll just let it float out a little bit further. Where is it? Over there. So we're going to be above that platform, that asteroid there. We'll let this come to a stop, and then we'll have to remove the cockpit again. So this should be all right, because like we saw before, it will go further out past this asteroid, but it definitely shouldn't come in any closer. So we shouldn't hit it again. So we don't need to be in here. We need to get rid of this first. There we go. I'm just going to make sure that everything, before we do that, everything is set to nobody. Maybe that means something will shoot at it. No, nobody should be, or I'm still not, see, some people have told me not to use nobody for that, but it seems to have not done anything wrong so far. Anyway, so we get the thrust override, and that did look good, although before we check, that's going to be the right way again. There we go. Let's hope this works. And on. Where you go? Just fly with it a little bit, and then we'll get back to the station so that way we can remote control it if needs be. I'm just hoping it doesn't go straight into this asteroid here. That's cutting it close. Why is it turning so quickly? That's a bit close for my liking. Hopefully it goes wider on the way back. Oh, I just put it on a wider orbit and then didn't turn down the pitch. So it's highly likely this is going to go barreling straight into the station. At least it looks like it's going to miss. See, I should have reduced that pitch to about half, maybe three quarters what it was then. I can still do that from the station. Just please don't hit any of that. Is that going to pass through the middle? Oh. This is ridiculous. Get into here. That was the wrong button. There we go. I just got to drop in frames a second there. That is coming back, isn't it? I think it might have rotated on an axis. So how about we just quickly... Why can't I get it? Is it because I changed the ownership? Everything's going wrong. Well, if I can't get that, then I might as well just sit out here and watch. And just hope, because it seems to be barreling off into nothingness. No, we're coming down. We're still getting further away. See, so that's where we... Is that where we started over there? Where's the hangar? That's the hangar door, yes. So that's where we started on that one. So it's coming back down to its original position over there, except it's a lot further out. We're about to lose contact with it if it... No, it's coming back. Okay. So predictions on to which of these asteroids going to hit. Where are we? See, hopefully it doesn't come back up through here again. That's a little bit close. I'd like it to go out that side. Just so that we don't have to be looking both ways before flying anywhere. Because even though there is a lot of space, it is still probably going to happen that someone's just going to fly out of this hangar and then be collected by a passing satellite. Okay, here we go. It's coming closer. See the speck? The solar panels glinting in the sunlight. Now, is it going to come back and hit that station? I don't really... That pitch is coming this way, isn't it? Yes, it's getting closer. Right, I think... That's a little close. And there it goes. Is it going... Ooh. That's... Actually holding my breath there. I'm going to come over and sit next to this moon and see if this how regular this orbit is. If I can trust it not to hit this moon. Not that there's much I can do about it, because apparently that I didn't read up enough on how that ownership stuff works. I should do that, because I can't access it from that station and remote control it. Do you have to both own the station and that instead of... That would make sense, because you wouldn't be able to control things owned by nobody. It's just that... I wish there was a way to make it available to everyone, because in the future we're expecting there to be different factions with different people, you know, so we can do different things. We're not just constantly going to be building at this station. When we get bored of that, we're going to move on, you know, to different factions and maybe a little bit of fighting, maybe, you know, working together, trading, just, you know, little things like that, whatever takes our fancy. But we still want this station to be a communal one. And there's no way to sort of be part of two factions at the same time, which would be kind of what we want. We want to be a faction of both the communal stuff, so everyone can use that, but at the same time be in a separate faction so that we can take advantage of all of that. So the only way we've been able to do that so far is if we make this owned by nobody, so that when people split off into another faction, they can still come back and, you know, use things like the refineries and so forth. And this satellite is supposed to be another communal property. I didn't really think that through, though. It's good that that's 4,000 meters, because that's nowhere near that asteroid. It's about 2,000 meters past that now. You can see that dot. The render distance on this thing is really far. I can still see it out there. But yeah, I don't know how to... I don't know if the game has that depth to it yet. There's sort of no way... It's a little bit too simplistic and, to be honest, a bit annoying to have to, when working with a group, to constantly be doing all of that. And yeah, I think that's something that they're going to have to work on in the future. Right, here it comes. It's a bit... I think that's fairly regular. So it's about 150 meters at its closest, it seems, to that moon. I'm going to wait here for one more rotation. Okay, here we go. 600 meters out. And it looks like... that's roughly where it was before. It seems to have gone a little bit further to the right as I was looking at it then. I don't think I moved far enough for that to make that sort of a difference. But I don't think it's going to come into contact with any of this. We've just got to make sure we don't build there. so that was the thing with the solar panels, is that because they're not quite enough to power it, I was just sort of thinking about it then, as I was trying to work out why it sort of tumbled. But then I remembered that if it's not powering all those thrusters, constantly at a constant rate, as in a solar panel moves just slightly out of the sunlight, it means that the power those thrusters get are a little bit less. So I'm assuming that means that it will wobble a little bit. It won't be able to keep a very constant orbit. It will move around, and I'm assuming that's what happened when I launched, because I did launch it to go like this, rather than on this, the path that it is now. Did that just disappear? That just disappeared for a second. So that means that the sunlight to the solar panels were cut. So it managed to tumble into a position where, I don't like the sound of that, because if that cuts out when it's on the way up towards this asteroid and it veers off straight, it's going to explode. You know what? One more pass. Let's just test this fully. This time it seems to have moved even further to the right. I'm not sure, I'll have to watch this back, but I'm pretty sure it came over this side, didn't it? It wasn't that far over there. I'm in the same spot as I was before, and it looks like it's... That's roughly where it was before, wasn't it? I think that's... Okay, so that orbit might be a little bit more stable than I thought. I still don't like the way it cut out there for a second. Anyway, So what happened this time is that I have set up a satellite that I'm not very confident in maintaining a stable orbit. So at any stage, that could run into something that you know, we don't want it to run into. That's great, isn't it? Anyway, thank you for watching this very haphazard video, just as a train goes past outside. One of the many advantages to living near a train line. but anyway, thank you for watching. Goodbye. No, it isn't goodbye. I just worked it out. I was just watching those numbers go past, and it was just as it went past about the 5,016 meter mark, which makes me... And then it came straight back in, so it looks like it'll blink out every time it goes past that 5,016 meter mark. It's not a problem with it tumbling out of control and not having the sun's power. It's that it goes out of the range of the antenna. And hopefully once we get a better communications system set up here... I don't even know if there's an antenna on this thing. I think it's just a beacon. The antenna might have been taken out by a meteor. So it's better than I thought. Anyway, this time for real, goodbye.